What's up, guys? This is Marcia here with another episode of the Lady Strong Fit Cast. I have a very special gay LSF member, Rosa. Rosa has been with us for a year. We're going to be sharing her story with you guys today. So the topic we're going to talk about is simple ways to get strong in 2022.
So the big question is this: how were two women who didn't cheat and purchase a gym franchise model, how were they able to spread their mission and purpose by empowering and transforming hundreds of women's lives through fitness, nutrition, mindset, and accountability with a micro gym business model of women only? That is the question, and this podcast will give you the answer. We are Lady Strong Fitness.
How are you today?
I'm doing good.
Thank you so much for taking the time out of your schedule. I know you're in your car right now. You're about to get a 6:25 p.m. workout in, so we won't keep you long. But I just want you to kind of tell the audience a little bit about yourself, and we'll kind of go from there.
Okay. I am in my 40s. I'm 41. I have two older kids in their 20s. This was probably the first time that I actually worked out in my life. I mean, I'd done other like diets, but working out, this was the first time. And I never thought that it would be something that I would actually enjoy.
Yeah. That's inspiring to hear by itself. So let me ask you, what was it that kept you going? First time doing it, were you nervous? And if so, how did you feel? And then what kept you going?
So just to even start, I have a friend who was a member here, and she talked highly about it. But at first, what I did was I went and joined another gym. I was going a few times a week, and, you know, I would do the treadmill and look around, and I was very, very intimidated. But she was so excited during, like, while she did her workouts, that I was like, no, I got to keep it up. I still was going to this other gym, and I didn't know what I was doing. So it was intimidating and frustrating. Mm-hmm. So finally I said, listen, I'm going to go with you. And then the first few times I thought I was going to die. And then after that, I was hooked.
I love it.
I was hooked. Yeah.
You are extremely consistent right now. Are you working out? Is it about 3 to 4 times per week? Correct me if I'm wrong.
It's five times.
Oh, it is five. Mm-hmm. Okay. Monday so I know for some people, I want to kind of take a step back. For some people that are maybe just starting their fitness journey, that could be a little bit intimidating. Yeah. So is that when you first started Lady Strong, can you tell them how often were you working out?
Yeah, I started twice a week. And then even after twice a week, I started to notice changes. So then it became even more motivating. So then I added another day. So I was consistently doing 3 times a week. And if I would miss one of my normal days, I would make it up on another day. But then it was like still noticing, learning more. While even when it was just the 3 days, I was learning so much about what your body needed, what it could look like and stuff. And then that's when I started realizing it wasn't so much like what the scale was saying,
yeah,
but what I was seeing myself.
Sure.
And then it wasn't actually up until I think it was November, this past November, where I started doing 5 times.
That's awesome.
And that was just more of I see the results. I want the results. I feel better health-wise. I'm better. So it made sense for me.
For sure. Yeah. I love that. So fast forwarding a year later, you've lost approximately 30 pounds, and we talked about the scaled victories. Let's talk about those non-scaled victories. What did you see differently a year later, like after, you know, going to Lady Strong consistently?
My muscles.
Yeah.
So to be very specific, I was very, I was not blessed with a butt. And it got to the point where one day I was like turning around in the mirror. I was like, what is that bump?
Yeah. I love it.
Yeah. And it was very, very exciting to see. Very exciting. The muscles in my thighs, like my legs, I've always had thick thighs, but now it's not like thick thighs. Now there's like muscles in my thighs.
Yeah.
And I don't have a problem. Before I was always like self-conscious about my thick thighs. And now it's like, yeah, I got thick thighs.
I love it. I can see it. You're like gleaming ear to ear. You know, you have a lot of confidence now. Honestly, you really do. Yes. So we're talking about all the good things. We're making it seem like this is an easy journey for you. Let's talk about the not so sexy things. What was the most difficult thing for you throughout this entire journey thus far?
I think I would say staying consistent, staying consistent. Even at first, if I would miss a day, I wasn't in that mindset of making it up. It was more like, oh, you know, it was Mondays were one of my normal days. Couldn't make it on Monday. Oh, I'll just wait till Wednesday. Instead of saying I'll go Tuesday, or if this is going to sound weird, but if plans came up, if I got invited somewhere, the gym was the first thing I was cutting out.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll go. I'll just cancel my class. It was staying consistent and making it one of my priorities.
Oh, I love that.
Because when it's not the priority, then it's what falls off right away.
100%. Yeah. So it's almost like you're treating it like an appointment you can't miss, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. It's like a routine. You know, we don't miss dates with our girlfriends or going out to eat and, you know, and making time for family, but it's like, you have to make time for yourself. So It's so cool to hear you say that. My next question for you is that what would be your advice for someone that's starting their fitness journey, or they're on the fence and they want to maybe give up because they're not necessarily seeing any difference within their journey. So what would be your advice to them?
It would be to stick with it and to be patient. Because my view at first was the same thing. If I'm working hard at, you know, I'm working out now, you know, I thought in a few months, I'll see some results of what I want to see. But even a year into this, I think I'm more excited right now than I was when I did start seeing some of the results. Like, I still keep getting excited and I keep getting excited. And that year went by really fast. Yeah. For me, it went by really fast.
Yeah.
But those points, they keep getting you excited over and over again. I mean, it could be a new muscle or, you know, lifting heavier weights or whatever it is, but you just got to stick with it because 100%. it will pay off.
So ladies, if you are a fly on the wall listening in right now, stick with it. Rosa says, stick with it.
Yeah.
I would 100% agree with you. So Paula, shout out to Coach Paula. She's actually the one that had nominated you for a member spotlight. She speaks very highly of you. She's like, she's such a hard worker. She needs to be acknowledged. And it was really cool to hear you, you know, without any hesitation, like, heck yeah, I'll do it. I would love to. So I want to thank you for coming on the show today. One other thing before I let you go here is that, we've seen a lot of women come on the show, and I guess I'd like to ask this question. What is your most favorite thing about Lady Strong? Just to kind of paint a picture for someone that, again, that's maybe on the fence about it.
Okay. So Coach Paula, I love her. I love her. But I think what's made it easier for me, what's made it easier for me to stick with it is the family. The girls, the coaches, the people that work here, the people that work out here. It's not like, it doesn't feel like, oh, I'm going to the gym. It's more like, yay, I'm going to the gym. I get to see the people that I enjoy being around.
For sure.
That makes it so much easier. And that's not, in my opinion, that's not something that you can get at, like, you know, a big chain gym and it's a big deal for me. For me, it's a big deal. Yeah.
100%. I love that. Family is everything. We're like your second family.
Yeah.
Very cool. So with that being said, honestly, Rosa, thank you again so much for coming on the show today. Ladies, again, as Rosa says, stick with it, be consistent, don't give up. So with that being said, ladies, have a blessed day, and we'll catch you on the next episode of the Lady Strong Fitcast. Take care. Bye.
Thank you.